I have found it, and especially recently, that the message of the church has been muddled. It's muddled. But we as Christians, we need to be clear about what we are really about. When Peter wrote his epistle, his second epistle, he said this: I will make every effort to see that after my departure, you will be able to remember these things. And isn't that truly the desire of every single teacher, that people will remember what they have been saying to them over and over and over again? You see, the church needs to be clear. Peter wanted to be clear. Christians, we need to be clear. Ministry needs to be clarified in word and in deed. This is really the great responsibility of anybody that teaches, whether it's in children's ministry or youth ministry or women's ministry or men's ministry or up at the pulpit or just out on the street talking to people about the gospel or talking to a friend about the gospel or talking to a family member about the gospel. We need to be clear. We need to be clear because today's theological vagueness is at an all-time high. We need to be clear in the proclamation of the gospel. There needs to be a clear return, a clear proclamation of biblical truth. This is truly a 1 Corinthians chapter 2 principle. Paul the apostle said, "For I determined to know nothing about you save Jesus Christ and him crucified." That's all Paul wanted to know about his fellow believers. Well, why? Because today's philosophies don't heal the broken heart. They don't break the chains of enslaved people or relieve guilt. In a phrase, listen, men, women, boys, girls, today, people don't need to hear our comments. They need to receive our Christ. They need to accept our Christ. They need to meet Jesus as their Savior. And so we must labor to ensure that our message is clear. And so let me be clear. The Declaration of Independence does not save people from their sins. The Second Amendment does not save people from their sins. And listen, I am not preaching pacifism by any means, but quite frankly, the church can be a lot louder about the Second Amendment than they are about the gospel. We're loud about the Second Amendment, but we're pacifists when it comes to the gospel. We need to be clear. We need to be clear about the gospel. The church's message is muddled in America. And I'm not saying that it's getting muddled. It is muddled today. We need to be clear about the true message of what we need to be communicating to the world around us. We need to be clear about the gospel.